Welcome once again everyone to another episode of Race to IAS Current Affairs Guru. Today we are going to discuss some important current events that has happened between 1st and 14th of June. The first one is regarding a scheme launched by Madhya Pradesh government named Rozgar Setu. It is aimed to help secure employment for skilled workers who have returned to the state due to COVID-19 pandemic. After such workers requiring employment are identified, the government will contact factory, workshop owners and contractors who are overseeing infrastructure projects such as road and bridge construction. The state government will thus act as a setu or bridge between the workers and employers too, so that both are benefited. The Prime Minister's office has declared that PM CARES Fund is not within the ambit of RTAI. So what is PM CARES Fund all about? The PM CARES or Prime Minister's Citizens Assistance and Relief in Emergency Situations Fund accepts donations and provides relief during the COVID-19 pandemic and other similar emergencies. Now, the Prime Minister's office has stated that the fund is not a public authority within the ambit of the RTA Act of 2005, and the government is thus not liable to disclose details on the creation and operation of the fund. This has reduced the transparency of the operation of the fund. This slide provides further details regarding the fund. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding Champions Platform, which stands for Creation and Harmonious Application of Modern Processes for Increasing the Output and National Strength, launched to empower the MSMEs. It was launched by the Prime Minister. It aims to make the smaller units big by solving their grievances, encouraging support, helping and hand-holding. Next is regarding UltraSwitch, a disinfection unit to disinfect a wide range of materials, including personal protective equipments or PPEs, electronic items, fabrics, etc. It has been designed by the Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Sciences or INMAS, the Delhi-based laboratory of DRDO. The system is double-layered with a specialized ozone sealant technology, assuring trapping of ozone for the necessary disinfection cycle. It also has catalytic converter to ensure environment-friendly exhaust, that is, only oxygen and water. Next news item is that INS Jalashwa, deployed by the Indian Navy for Operation Samudra Setu, entered Tuticorin Harbor on 2nd June 2020 with 685 Indian nationals evacuated from Colombo in Sri Lanka. Embarkation of Indian nationals was facilitated by the Indian mission in Sri Lanka. INS Jalashwa would now be proceeding to Maldives for repatriation of approximately 700 Indian nationals on 5th June 2020. Next is regarding Cyclone Nisarga. It was formed in the Arabian Sea and is headed towards the coastline of North Maharashtra and South Gujarat. It is likely to hit the coastlines between Harihareshwar in Raigad district, just south of Mumbai, and Daman, just below Gujarat coast, as is depicted in the picture. And what about the strength of the cyclone? As at its strongest, Nisarga would be associated with wind speeds in the range of 95 to 105 km per hour. In comparison, another recent cyclone, Amphan, which originated in Bay of Bengal, had speeds above 180 km per hour and was classified as a super cyclone. Cyclones formed in the Bay of Bengal side of the North Indian Ocean are more frequent and stronger than those in the Arabian Sea side. Some more information regarding the cyclones can be obtained from this slide. Next is regarding the coronavirus type that is the second most prevalent in India, which has been identified by the scientists recently. The newly identified type that the scientists have named A3I comprised 41% of the total analyzed. The most dominant coronavirus type in India is the A2A, which comprised 62% of the total analyzed. With this, there are 11 SARS-CoV-2 types identified globally, with at least 6 of them identified in India. Next news item says that the Kolkata Port Trust will be renamed as Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Port Trust. The Kolkata Port Trust is the first major port as well as the only riverine port of the country. And Shyama Prasad Mukherjee was an eminent jurist, academician, thinker and leader of the masses. This slide provides additional details regarding the four other ports which got renamed in the recent times. Next is regarding World Environment Day. World Environment Day or WED is celebrated on 5th June every year. This year's theme of the day is biodiversity. Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the nodal agency for observing the day in India. In view of the prevalent situation due to COVID-19 pandemic, the ministry will be holding virtual celebrations of the World Environment Day in this year's theme with a focus on Nagar Van or Urban Forest. Next is regarding the Global Vaccine Summit 2020. Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi addressed the virtual Global Vaccine Summit hosted by UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson, in which over 50 countries, business leaders, UN agencies, civil society, government ministers, heads of state and country leaders have participated. India pledged $50 million to Gavi, the International Vaccine Alliance. Global Vaccine Summit, or Gavi, helps vaccinate almost half the world's children against deadly and debilitating infectious diseases. Next is regarding an internship program named TULIP, which stands for the Urban Learning Internship Program, launched jointly by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and All India Council for Technical Education, or AICTE. It is a program for providing internship opportunities to fresh graduates in all urban local bodies, or ULBs, and smart cities across the country. Next is regarding International Day of Innocent Children Victims of Aggression. International Day of Innocent Children Victims of Aggression is observed globally on 4th June every year. This day is to acknowledge the pain suffered by children throughout the planet who are victims of physical, mental and emotional abuse. The next news item says that the scientists from the Center for Nano and Soft Matter Sciences, or CENS, which is an autonomous institute of the Department of Science and Technology, have found out a low-cost and effective way to generate hydrogen from water using molybdenum dioxide as a catalyst. Molybdenum dioxide has the potential to replace the currently employed catalyst platinum, which is expensive and has limited resources. It is a conducting metal oxide that is one of the low-cost catalysts with a good efficiency and stability for hydrogen evolution. This slide provides some additional information regarding the development. Next is regarding the strengthened India-Australia partnership. India and Australia raised their relationship to a comprehensive strategic partnership after a virtual summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison, who concluded 9 agreements, including a mutual logistics support agreement, or MLSA, and issued a joint declaration on a shared vision for maritime cooperation in the Indo-Pacific. The two countries also agreed to increase the frequency of meetings between the two prime ministers, and it took the 2+2 format of bilateral meetings to the level of foreign and defense ministers, who will meet to discuss strategic issues at least every 2 years. Next is regarding a 500 crore rupees fund established by RBI to boost payment infrastructure in the country. The RBI has created a Payment Infrastructure Development Fund, or PIDF, to encourage acquirers to deploy points of sale or POS infrastructure, both physical and digital modes, in Tier 3 to Tier 6 centers and northeastern states. RBI will make an initial contribution of Rs 250 crore to the PIDF, covering half of the fund, while the remaining contribution will be from card issuing banks and card networks operating in the country. Next is regarding World Food Safety Day. The second World Food Safety Day, or WFSD, will be celebrated on 7th June 2020 to draw attention and inspire action to help prevent, detect and manage foodborne risks, contributing to food security, human health, economic prosperity, agriculture, market access, tourism and sustainable development. The first World Food Safety Day was celebrated last year, that is in 2019. The theme of this year's Food Safety Day is Food Safety, Everyone's Business. Next is regarding World Oceans Day. World Oceans Day is being celebrated on June 8 every year, and this year's theme is Innovation for a Sustainable Ocean. Many countries have celebrated this special day since 1992 following the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development held in Rio de Janeiro. Next is regarding a nanotechnology-based disinfectant spray developed by Defense Institute of Advanced Technology, a deemed university in Pune, to combat COVID-19 by disinfecting all types of surfaces. It has been named Ananya. This nanotechnology-assisted formulation will not only stop the novel coronavirus from entering human body, but it will also kill the virus when the virus comes in contact with the formulation layers in masks and PPEs. This is a water-based spray and will be effective for more than 24 hours after the spray. The Indian Air Force has designed, developed and inducted an airborne rescue pod for isolated transportation, or ARPIT. This pod will be utilized for evacuation of critical patients with infectious diseases, including COVID-19, from high altitude area, isolated and remote places. The design integrates life support and monitoring instruments, that is defibrillator with a multiple monitor, multi-para monitor, pulse oximeter, infusion pumps, etc. Long arm gloves for use by healthcare professionals and a power pack with high endurance. The World Bank estimates that the Indian economy will contract by 3.2% in this fiscal year as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic and its associated restrictions. It also estimates that the world economy as a whole is said to witness its deepest recession since World War II, with a forecast contraction of 5.2% this year. Countries most reliant on global trade, tourism, external financing, and commodity exports are likely to be hit the hardest. The next news item is regarding the QS World University Rankings. It is a global ranking event which rates universities all over the world. According to it, the top 5 Indian Institutes of Technology and the Indian Institutes of Science have all dropped in their rankings this year. Only the newer IITs in Guwahati and Hyderabad were able to show improvement. The total number of Indian institutions in the top 1000 global list has also fallen from 24 to 21. Despite the Center's flagship Institutes of Eminence scheme launched 2 years ago in a bid to boost the Indian presence in these global rankings. Next is regarding Coral Triangle Day. First of all, what is Coral Triangle? It is world's epicenter of marine diversity and one of the 3 mega ecological complexes in our planet, together with the Congo Basin and the Amazon rainforest. It is a vast ocean expanse that geographically spreads across 6 countries in Asia and the Pacific, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Papua New Guinea, Solomon Islands, and Timor-Leste. The Coral Triangle Day, which is celebrated on June 9 every year, is an annual open-sourced event that brings together individuals, organizations, and establishments on one special day of the year to shed light on ocean conservation and the numerous ways to protect and conserve the Coral Triangle. Next is regarding the reported increase in the number of Asiatic lions in Gir Forest region of Gujarat. Gujarat prides itself on hosting Asiatic lions exclusively, and their numbers have now risen to an estimated 674. Once seen as threatened by extinction, the lion population has grown by almost 29% from the last count in 2015. Additional information regarding the Asiatic lions are given in this slide. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding Nature Index 2020, which is a ranking system based on the research published on the top journals, a measure of research quality. 3 of the autonomous institutions of the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, have found their place among top 30 Indian institutions, including universities, IITs, IASERs, and research institutions and labs in the list. The names of the important institutes which have found a place in the list are given in the slide. Next is regarding a flood warning system for Mumbai, developed by Ministry of Earth Sciences in close coordination with the Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. It is named iFlows Mumbai. It is developed as a state-of-the-art integrated flood warning system for Mumbai to enhance the resilience of the city of Mumbai by providing early warning for flooding, especially during high rainfall events and cyclones. Next is regarding India's rising forex reserves. So what are forex reserves? Forex reserves are external assets in the form of gold, SDRs or special drawing rights of the IMF, and foreign currency assets accumulated by India and controlled by the Reserve Bank of India. Forex reserves increases when we have an inflow of foreign capital or currency, and it decreases when we have an outflow of foreign capital or currency. Having a good amount of forex reserves is always good for a country because it will support its import requirements and will absorb shocks during the times of currency volatility. Now, it is being reported that India's forex reserves are increasing at a time the whole world economy is in crisis. How is it possible? There are mainly 2 reasons for it. First one is the rise in investment in foreign portfolio investors in Indian stocks and foreign direct investments or FDIs. This means increase in foreign capital. The other reason is the fall in crude oil prices has brought down the oil import bill. This has minimized the currency outflow from our country and thus contributed to the increase in forex. This slide explains in detail how an increase in forex reserves is beneficial. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding World Day Against Child Labor. It is observed annually on 12th June. World Day Against Child Labor 2020 focused on the impact of COVID-19 crisis on child labor. The crisis can push millions of vulnerable children into child labor. This year, the World Day is conducted as a virtual campaign and is being organized jointly with the Global March Against Child Labor and the International Partnership for Cooperation on Child Labor in Agriculture, or IPCCLA. Next, the National Highway Authority of India, or NHAI, under Ministry of Road Transportation and Highways, has gone fully digital with the launch of unique cloud-based and artificial intelligence-powered big data analytics platform, Data Lake, and project management software. All project documentation, contractual decisions, and approvals are now being done through this platform only. Next is regarding the Challenger Deep. It is regarded as the deepest part of the ocean. According to National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA of USA, the average depth of the ocean is about 12,100 feet and the deepest part is called the Challenger Deep, which is located below the surface of the Western Pacific Ocean. It is approximately 36,200 feet deep, which is about 3 times deeper than the average depth. It is located in the Western Pacific Ocean and was discovered by the British ship HMS Challenger between 1872 and 1876. Next, noted Indian-American soil scientist Ratan Lal gets 2020 World Food Prize for developing and mainstreaming a soil-centric approach to increasing food production that conserves natural resources and mitigates climate change. Details of World Food Prize is given in the slide. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding a healthcare supply chain portal named Arogyapath, launched by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, or CSIR, to provide real-time availability of critical healthcare supplies in view of the deadly coronavirus pandemic. Arogyapath would serve manufacturers, suppliers, and customers. It is an integrated public platform that provides single-point availability of key healthcare goods. Some additional information regarding Arogyapath are given in this slide. Next is regarding a strange phenomena observed in Lonar Lake of Maharashtra, which where the color of its water turned pink recently. Samples from Lonar Lake has been sent for testing. The lake was formed more than 50,000 years ago when a 2 million ton crater impacted the earth to create a depression, 1.83 kilometer in diameter and 150 meter deep. It finds mention in ancient texts like Skanda Purana, Padma Purana, and also it finds mention in Aini Akbari. Next is regarding Global Partnership on Artificial Intelligence, or GPAI. India joined the league of leading economies including USA, UK, European Union, Australia, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, Mexico, New Zealand, Republic of Korea, Singapore to launch the Global Partnership on Artificial Intelligence, GPAI, which is pronounced as GPAI. GPAI is an international and a multi-stakeholder initiative to guide the responsible development and use of AI, grounded in human rights, inclusion, diversity, innovation, and economic growth. Some additional relevant information regarding the partnership is given in this slide. Next is regarding Indian Gas Exchange. Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas and Steel launched the Indian Gas Exchange, or IGX, first nationwide online delivery-based gas trading platform. IGX will be a delivery-based trading platform for delivery of natural gas. The platform is fully automated with a web-based interface to provide seamless trading experience to the customers. Next is regarding the famous Rajaparba festival of Odisha. Rajaparba is Odisha's 3-day unique festival celebrating the onset of monsoon and the earth's womanhood. The festival is essentially the celebration of the earth's womanhood. It is believed that during this time, the mother earth or Bhudevi undergoes menstruation. As it is a celebration of womanhood, a lot of the focus is on young women who wear new clothes, apply alata on their feet and enjoy folk songs while swinging on decorated rope swings. Next is regarding the World Investment Report 2020 by the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development for or UNCTAD. It says that India was the 9th largest recipient of FDI in 2019 with $51 billion of inflows during the year, which is an increase from the $42 billion of FDI received in 2018. Most of the investments were in the information and communication technology and the construction industry. So that's all for today, guys. And now Race to IAS has started foundation courses for school and college students, where you can prepare for the prestigious civil service examination at the comfort of your own home. Live classes will be provided. Details and links are provided in the description box below. We are now presenting before you NewsUp, an exciting quiz competition based on daily news. The quiz presents before you an opportunity to win exciting prizes along with the reading your daily newspaper. All you have to do is to go to Race to IAS website and register your name there. Any student studying in Standard 6 to 12 can participate in the program. Duration of the quiz will be of 5 minutes between 8 to 9 p.m. from Monday to Friday. There will be no quiz on Saturday and Sunday. So all of you go to Race to IAS website now itself and register your names and participate in the quiz program. And in this way, you can make this lockdown periods much more fun and productive. Don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok and Hello to get our regular updates. The links are provided in the description box below. Also, download our Junior IAS app from Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quizzes. We'll meet again next week. Until then, stay safe, guys. Goodbye.